Hi, welcome again to our Bible study session. We shall be looking at the topic that says making a vow unto God. In the course of our study, we shall be trying to look into the questions: are we supposed to make a vow unto God as children of God? When we make our vow, are we supposed to redeem or are we not supposed to redeem? And other more questions that, by the grace of God, we shall be looking into the scriptures to find answers to those questions. Shall we pray? Father, we give you praise. We honor you. We say, let your name be exalted, Lord, in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit of God, we invite you this moment as we go into the study of the word, that you be with us, you teach us, you instruct us in Jesus' name. We cover and seal this moment with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We'll be taking our first reading. This lesson will run into a series. This one is the part one of it. So after this one, it might go to part two or part three, depending on. So today we shall be taking our reading from Ecclesiastes chapter 5. I'll take it from verse 4 to verse 5. And it says, when thou vowest a vow unto God, defer not to pay it. For he had no pleasure in fools. Pay that which thou hast vowed. Better is it that thou should not vow than that thou should vow and not pay. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, the place we just read now is telling us that when we make a vow unto God, remember our topic. He said, when we make a vow unto God, that means there are actually people that could make vows but not unto God. So that is why our concentration is making a vow unto God. So he says, when we make our vow unto God, that we should try and pay our vow. That's what the scripture is telling us. We have to make sure we pay the vow that we have made. Now, somebody might be asking, what do they actually mean by making a vow? Okay, for instance, you are in church or you're at home or at your quiet time, and there is this thing you're asking from God, and you feel, I have prayed. I have done this, I've done that, it's not coming forth. Just like Elizabeth did, which is one of the people we shall be treating in the course of this lesson. Elizabeth was seeking for a son from God. She prayed every year she would go to Shiloh and pray and all that. It was not forthcoming. Do you know that thing she was looking for from God actually came when she decided to tie it with a vow? And what was the vow? Somebody might ask. She just simply said, Father, if you bless me with a child, I will give him back to you. And that was it. And you know, such, you might think, is a careless statement. Some might think she was serious about it. Of course she was serious about it. She had to tie her faith to the fact that, Father, this is my part. I have played my own part. I have made a promise that if you give me a child, I'll give him back to you. That's a vow. There are no two ways to make vows. Vow is that promise that you have promised God, that if you do this for me, this is what I will do in return. Now, God decides to do that for you. And probably you forgot. Or probably you think, it's one of those careless talks. It doesn't mean anything. Can I tell you, it does mean something. It does mean something. So, the place we read in Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 4, it says, defer not to pay your vows when you make them. Why? Because God had no pleasure in fools. So if you make your vow and you do not redeem it, God looks at you as a fool. That's what the scripture says. I'm not the one that said it. You see, God had no pleasure in fools. Pay that who thou have vowed. So now he's telling us that if we make our vow, we should try and pay it. If we do not pay it, God sees us as fools. Now, verse 5 says, this is an instruction now in verse 5. He said, better is it that thou should not vow. It is better for us if in the heat of that moment we decide to keep our mouth shut than to make a vow that we know we will not be able to redeem. Because, to be honest with you, nobody forces you to make a vow. Nobody cajoles you to make a vow. Nobody talks you into making a vow. It is of your own personal decision. You are the one on your own. You decide that, God, if you do this for me, I will do this for you. Nobody encouraged you to do it. So now the question is, if you are the one who had decided on your own to make a vow before God, why would you not redeem it? Why would you tell God, play your part and I will play my part? At the end of the day, God plays his own part and you decide not to play your own part. Now, the scripture is telling us that it is better that you don't attempt it at all than that you make a vow and you do not redeem it. That same verse 5, it says, better is it that thou should not vow than that thou should vow and not pay. When the Bible says better for you, you know what it means. So, now we know what it means to make a vow. And now we have come across the instruction, the advice that the scripture had given unto us, that it is better we do not make a vow than that we make a vow and we do not redeem it. So, I will ask us today, if there is any way we have made any vow before God, I will advise that you run quickly. Go to that place you have made that vow and redeem. And if there is any vow you have made that you cannot remember, I will advise that you tell God, Father, please, let the Holy Spirit of God remind you. Ask the Spirit of God to remind you so that you will go and fulfill that vow. It does not matter how big or how small. The Bible did not tell us that the one you should redeem is the massive one, or the one you should not redeem is the small one. It says, if you make your vow, redeem your vow. Because God does not have pleasure in any fool. Imagine God saying that. That means if you make your vow, you do not redeem it, you are seen as a fool. Praise the name of the Lord. I hope this place has been able to help us today to know that, one, do not be quick in making vows. Be prepared. Be ready. Make sure you know what you're saying. Make sure you know what you're doing. Nobody forces you into making any vow. And if you must make one, try and redeem your vow. Shall we pray? Father, we give you praise, we honor you, we adore you, we say let your name be exalted, my Lord and my King, in the name of Jesus. We love you, Jesus, we adore your name. Today, is there any way we have made vows that we have not been able to redeem? Father, we want to redeem. Have mercy upon us in Jesus' name. May our vows that we have not redeemed never stand against us in Jesus' name. Father, are there vows that we have made unto you that we have totally forgotten? We can forget, but you do not forget. Father, let your Holy Spirit, as we sleep tonight, let your Spirit begin to minister those vows and the places that we need to go for redemption of those vows in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we do not take pleasure in making vows and not redeeming them. Lord, any vow that we have made that we have not redeemed, Father, we want to redeem them. In the name of Jesus Christ, let them come flooding. We want to remember every bit of vow that we have made before you so that we will go and redeem them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Can I say, if you're not born again, you need to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I'm a sinner. You raise my name from the book of death and write my name in the book of light. Today, acknowledge that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I acknowledge that he came and died on the cross of Calvary for my sake. Today, I accept him as my Lord and personal Savior in the name of Jesus. All to you, Jesus, I surrender. accept me into your kingdom. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Congratulations if you did say that prayer. Now you're born again. Look for any Bible-believing church around you. Go there, worship God, and He'll perfect all that concerns you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. If this video has blessed you in any way, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. Click share, like. If there's any topic you want to be treated on this forum, leave a message. If you have any comment, feedback, or suggestion, leave a message, and God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Thanks for watching.